Filan, former Mr. Westlife, and we're going to be talking to him very, very shortly. Before that, room,
he's going to get us in the mood for the weekend. He's got his brand new single out, Everything to Me, and here he is with that.
Life is like a jigsaw, where would you start? If you got the picture, like a script on your heart. Lay out all the pieces, one by one. Staring into dust, the answer never comes. So I take a breath, cause I need time to figure this all out. Got lost inside when I thought I'd need, but I understand now. Tell me where I'm going, tell me what comes next. To know that it's not over, haven't even started yet. I just wanna get there, but I hope it's not too late. Cause the closer that I'm getting, the more I feel the way. Let's take a breath, take our time to figure this all out. I got lost inside what I thought I'd need, but I understand.
Shane's got a lot to talk about. He's got a big tale to tell, and we're going to be talking about what a year it's been for you.
It's been pretty crazy, yeah. Yeah, been pretty mad few years.
Up and down, up and down.
Up and down. Up and down.
Listen, we're going to talk about that when we come back after the break with the big interview. Shane's interview to come. The big interview we've got right after that is Kenny Sampson. We're going to be talking to him about the troubles he's been experiencing right after this. Don't go away.
Let's go back and revisit Westlife days. Now, a quarter of the band, Shane Filan, was a very busy man, 40 million records these guys sold, 14 years, just there in the recording studio, the concerts,
time,
the arena
it?
Tours, yeah. The TV programs and all that sort of thing. Then the split happened. Shane, though, he said, I can't give my music up. He decided to carry on, and you heard his music there today. The title, I forgot.
Everything to Me.
Everything.
That was lovely. It was really nice,
it's very
wasn't
different
it?
Sound,
yeah,
actually.
You.
We're going to chat to him about that and the whole new sound and his solo career, but we couldn't have you here without having a little
all right, okay.
Westlife.
Cool.
Raise me up so I can stand on mountains. Raise me up, you can, you give me back to you. But I sent you away, you're on the ground. Doesn't sound very
I'm thinking, watching that, 14 years, you and the guys all together, recording, touring, and now on your own.
It must be
very different.
It is, even sitting in the sofa, you know, we obviously all came here together and stuff like that so many times. Yeah, it is, it's very different routes. It's brand new, you know, everything I do, this is my first time on this morning, you know, every TV show or every radio show I do is just, I suppose, I'm getting used to it every day, but I'm really enjoying it, I'm really loving the vibe, the reaction.
It must have been a bit scary, was it daunting to start with?
It was, yeah, I think last week, you know, was a very kind of, obviously the song was coming out last weekend, and, you know, I woke up to a number ones on iTunes on Sunday, so that was an amazing feeling, and just the relief was like, okay.
My Rebecca was hopefully very happy. Very happy she was.
Your daughter?
She is, yeah. Rebecca, yeah.
She's yeah, that's right, yeah, yeah. I sent her a tweet.
Yeah, and you've got girls like that everywhere. And they're a bit bereft. They really don't know what to do. And I find it hard to believe that the rest of them won't follow you in some way, bit by bit. Why were you the first to break ranks, do you think? What have the rest of them got to do that they didn't want to go and do this?
For me, you know, I think we all needed to kind of... When we decided to break up 2 years ago, we kind of had that whole time to get used to it until the tour was over, which we did the farewell tour last year. So we had a lot of time to think about it. I think we're all trying to find individual paths in life, you know. But for me, it was singing. That's all I want to do is sing.
It's a bit like being an athlete or a footballer or something. Someone says, that's it, you're retired. So you can have, you know, all the adulation, all the money, whatever.
Yeah.
But it's what you do.
It is, yeah. It's what comes naturally to me, you know. It's what I love to do. I love to sing. When I was younger, I wanted to be a pop star, and I got to do that at the highest level with Westlife, obviously, and now I just want to keep singing. I just want to do what I love and get to do it, and it's, you know, the support I've got so far.
And you've still got Louis in your life.
I do, yeah. Louis managed me, yeah, obviously. I think, you know, that was very important for me because he's somebody that believes in me more than anybody. He's my biggest supporter, like, he's my number one band, and he's like, he's constantly, you know, he's just the number one person that is going to promote me and going to believe in me the most, and that's what you need in a manager.
But you need a manager, you need a good manager, and some people would say, well, you need to work as well, because you had that terrible situation in Ireland where you think you're doing the right thing, you're working for years and years and years, and you're building up your money, and you're investing it in property and in development. And as everybody knows now, the Irish economy and the Celtic Tiger and whatever thing collapses, and the whole Irish economy is based on property development. And how does it sting you? How does it affect you? Tell us.
Well, it was a very difficult time because, you know, you go through a lot in your kind of mind, go, why me? Why did I invest all my money in property? But at the time, it was the right thing to do. It was like the Celtic Tiger was booming. We're going back like 6 years, maybe 7 years, and it was just one of those things you think, you know, the Westlife might not last forever. You know, Brian had just left the year before. I had just had a baby. I was thinking, I need to invest some money here. I was lucky enough to have some money. We all did obviously very well at the Westlife, but I thought, what if at the time I didn't want to go solo. So I was thinking, I need to invest this. I need to look forward for the future. And I invested all in property and then lost it all in property.
And how much did you lose, do you reckon?
Oh, millions. It was crazy. It was like one of those things you kind of can't believe is happening, but it just started kind of crumbling down around you, and you get to a stage then where you're trying to keep it at bay, and you're paying out like crazy money, 50, 60, 70 grand a month.
Yeah, just to
every
be
month.
Interesting to do that.
And you literally lost everything. I mean, you lost home.
Yeah, I lost my house in Sligo, obviously, as part of it, which is obviously heartbreaking, you know, probably the most thing that really, you know, it was very difficult, but, you know, I have my kids, I have my wife, I have my voice, as Louis said.
We're talking
about
support,
the three things you need.
Louis, but the other constant rock and support is your lovely wife, Gillian.
Yeah, without a doubt, she was amazing. You know, she got me through so much, and it was a bit of a scary time, you know, straight after Westlife, obviously. I had no job, I had no band, I had no money, and I had no record deal. So Louis and Gillian together, Louis on the business side and Gillian on the kind of personal side, obviously, she was just amazing. She kept me positive. She kept me... When you're going through that, you kind of have to be positive. You have to look at it and go, listen, I need to fix this, but I'm going to be positive, and I'm going to just keep singing and see what happens. And that's what I kept thinking, you know, I'm going to keep singing, and if what works out for me, what's meant to be is meant to be for me.
And,
you know, it's...
And if you do pick yourself up the floor, off the floor, and you earn a few quid again, you're going to put it in properly, or not?
I'm going to stick to singing. You know, a good friend of mine said that to me. Just said, you know, if you're good at one thing in your life, stick to it.
Stick to it.
And I like to sing, so I'm definitely going to stick to singing from now on. But, you know, we don't know what the future's going to hold for me, but I'm getting to sing. The reaction's been good so far, so it's early days, but I'm just going to keep being positive and see what happens.
So the single, Everything To Me, when's the album out?
The single's out now. The album's coming in November, and there's a second single coming. Actually, in a couple of weeks, it's going to radio, so, you know, it's exciting.
Great.
Good luck.
Good to see you.
Thank you very much.
And every success. Keep positive.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank
you. And you know, Shane's just one of the many, many fantastic guests and memories we have for the past 6 weeks. Mm-hmm. If you've been out there and you've been watching us most days, thank you very much. If you haven't,